Hello everyone, how you all are? I hope everyone is safe and healthy at your home. Today, in this video, we'll learn about some basic concepts of chemical kinetics. Today, we'll start a new chapter, that is chemical kinetics. So in this video, we'll talk about some basic terms which are used in chemical kinetics. So let's begin. Whenever we introduce ourselves, we tell our name first. So it's our introductory video for chemical kinetics. So in this video, first of all, we'll define what do you mean by chemical kinetics. Now, what is chemical kinetics? Chemical kinetics is a branch of chemistry which deals with the study of the rate of chemical reaction, the factors which affects the rate of the chemical reaction, and the mechanism by which the chemical reaction proceeds. This is our definition of chemical kinetics. In our previous classes, we studied that reactions are number of types, means like displacement reaction, decomposition reaction, redox reaction, double displacement reaction, but according to chemical kinetics, we have some separate kind of reactions. First, very high speed reactions. These reactions occurs immediately, means within 10 to the power minus 12 or 10 to the power minus 16 seconds. Second, reactions are slow reactions. These reactions takes days or even months to complete. For example, rusting of iron. Third, reactions are those reactions which neither occur very fast nor occur very slow. Therefore, these reactions are known as moderate speed reactions. For example, hydrolysis of sucrose. The formula of sucrose is C12H22O11 because it is a kind of sugar, plus H2O because it is hydrolysis of sucrose. It gives C6H12O6, that is glucose, plus C6H12O6, that is fructose. So this is a moderate rate equation. Now, the main thing is, in chemical kinetics, the main reactions which we take in chemical kinetics are moderate speed reactions. Now, the question arises, why different reactions have different rates? We all know that a chemical reaction is proceeded by the breaking of old bonds and the formation of new bonds. But this is also a fact that each bond doesn't have equal strength. Means some bonds are very strong and some bonds are very weak. So different amount of energies are required to break different kinds of bond, and different kind of energies are evolved to form new kinds of bond. And this is the reason why some reactions occur very fast, some reactions occur very slow, and some reactions occur at a moderate speed. But here is one more question, that why ionic reactions occurs immediately. This is because in ionic reaction, the ionic reaction do not require breaking of bonds. Why? Because in ionic reaction, the ionic compound is already present in the ionic form in its aqueous solution. Now, there is a term, rate of reaction, because the whole definition of chemical kinetics is around this term, that is the rate of a chemical reaction. Now, what do you mean by rate of chemical reaction? Rate of chemical reaction is the change of concentration of either reactant or product with time is known as rate of reaction. Whenever a reaction occur, reactant goes on decreasing and the concentration of product goes on increasing. Means there is a change in the concentration of both reactant as well as products. So rate of reaction is the change in concentration of either reactant or product with time. In this, we'll represent the rate of the reaction by change in concentration divided by change in time. But there is one difference. when we are talking about change in the concentration of reactant, then the rate of the reaction becomes negative, means minus change in concentration of reactant divided by time taken. And when we talk about product, then it is change in concentration of product divided by time. There is no negative value.
Suppose reactant get converted into product. So according to definition, rate of reaction becomes decrease in reactant with time or increase in product with time. Here negative sign is there and in this positive sign is there. This negative sign doesn't mean that the rate of the reaction is negative, because what is rate of reaction? Rate of reaction is the speed with which the reaction occur, and we all know that speed never be negative. So this negative sign doesn't mean that the rate of the reaction is negative. This negative sign shows that the concentration of the reactant keeps on decreasing. Now let us take example of a reaction. PCl5 on decomposing gives PCl3 plus Cl2. Now if we write the rate of reaction for this reaction, it becomes negative change in concentration of PCl5 with time is equals to positive change in concentration of PCl3 with time, or is equals to positive change in concentration of chlorine with time. Here the reactant is PCl5, its concentration goes on decreasing, that's why here the term comes negative. But these two are products, their concentration keeps on increasing, that's why the term here occurs positive. Clear? Now on the basis of the definition, we can able to determine the unit of rate of reaction. Upper side it is concentration, here it is time. So what will be the unit? Unit is mole liter per second or mole liter per minute. If time is given in second, then it is mole liter per second, and if time is given in minute, then the unit becomes mole liter per minute. But in case of gaseous reactions, we are not able to calculate the concentration. In gaseous reactions, we'll calculate the pressure of that particular reactants or products. So in case of gaseous reaction, in place of concentration, we'll use the term pressure. Means rate of reaction is equals to decrease in the pressure of reactant divided by time taken is equals to increase in the pressure of product divided by time taken. And according to this, the unit of rate of reaction becomes atom per minute or atom per second, because we are using pressure in terms of concentration. Clear? Now next topic is average rate. Now here, what is rate of the reaction? We define rate of the reaction. That rate of the reaction is change in concentration of either reactant or product with time. So basically average rate is the above rate which we define. Average rate is actually the rate of the reaction which is the change in concentration of the product with time. So how we can able to express the average rate of the reaction? Average rate of the reaction is equals to delta X. Now what is delta X? Change in concentration divided by delta T. If we talk about reactant, then it becomes minus delta X, and if we talk about product, then it becomes plus delta X. Along with average rate, there is one more term, that is instantaneous rate. Now what is instantaneous rate? The change in the concentration of any one of the reactant or product at a particular instant of time is called instantaneous rate of reaction. Means there is a change in concentration of reactant, there is a change in concentration of product, but we are not taking too much time, we are taking a short period of time. At that period, if change is there, that is instantaneous rate of reaction, which is represented by R instantaneous is equals to minus dr upon dt or plus dp upon dt, where simple delta represent larger change, whereas symbol D represent smaller change. Therefore, in average rate of the reaction, delta is there, and in instantaneous rate of reaction, D is there. Previously, we saw that there is a reaction that PCl5, it gives PCl3 plus Cl2. For this reaction, when rate we have to return, it becomes minus change in concentration of PCl3 with time, or change in concentration of PCl3 with time, or change in concentration of Cl2 with time. Now let us consider one more equation. 2N2O5 gives 4NO2 plus O2. Can you able to recognize the difference between these two? Yes, these two are different from the number of moles. In this, 1 mole of PCl5 react to give 1 mole of PCl3 and 1 mole of Cl2. But in this reaction, 2 moles of N2O5 reacts to form 4 moles of NO2 and 1 mole of O2. Means the rate of disappearance of N2O5 is 2 times faster than the rate of formation of O2. Or the rate of formation of NO2 is 4 times faster than the rate of formation of O2. Now in this case, if we have to write the rate, then we will not able to write on this manner. Now what we'll do next? We'll express the rate of the reaction for these types of reaction equals to, there is rate of change of concentration of reactant, and yes, reactant decreases with time, so minus is there, but before delta N2O5 divided by delta T, I'll put one term, that is 1 by 2. 1 by 2 change in concentration of N2O5 divided by delta T, or 1 by 4 change in concentration of NO2 divided by delta T, or change in concentration of O2 divided by delta T. Now the rate of the formation of O2 and the rate of the disappearance of N2O5 becomes equal. Similarly, the rate of formation of O2 and the rate of formation of NO2 becomes equal. Let us consider one more example. C6, C12, H22, O11 plus H2O. It gives C6, H12, O6 plus C6, H12, O6. Means hydrolysis of sucrose. Now, in this, 1 mole of sucrose react with 1 mole of water to form 1 mole of glucose and 1 mole of fructose. Now, here also one problem is there in expressing the rate of reaction. And what is that problem? That problem is water. Because in this, we'll take the water in excess amount, as a result of which the change in concentration of water becomes negligible. So we'll not express the rate on the basis of change in concentration of water. So in this reaction, the rate of the reaction becomes either rate of disappearance of C12, H22, O11, or rate of formation of C6, H12, O6 with time, or rate of formation of C6, H12, O6 with time. Clear? Means in this rate, we'll not use H2O for describing the rate of the reaction. Why? Because it is present in excess. That's why it does not influence the rate of the reaction, because its concentration with time doesn't change significantly. Clear?
Now next, we'll discuss about the various factor which influence the rate of reaction. First factor is nature of reactant. Let us consider examples. NO plus O2 gives NO2. This is a fast reaction. CO plus O2 gives CO2. This is a slow reaction. In appearance, these two reactions appear same, but there is a difference in rate of these two reactions. Now, why there is a difference in the rate of these two reactions? Because of bond strength. CO bond is strong bond, therefore it takes more energy to break, that's why the reaction becomes slow, whereas NO bond is a weak bond, that's why it takes comparatively less time to break and the rate of the reaction becomes fast. So the first factor is nature of reactant. Now what is second factor? Second factor is use of catalyst. If a catalyst is there in the reaction, then the rate of the reaction becomes fast. So catalyst enhance the rate of the reaction without taking part in reaction. This is a property of a catalyst, that catalyst enhances the rate of the reaction but doesn't take part in chemical reaction. Or if the reactions are chemically revert, means if the reaction is a reversible reaction, then what a catalyst do? Catalyst help in attaining the equilibrium. Third factor is concentration of the reactant. We know that rate of the reaction is change in concentration of the reactant or decrease in concentration of the reactant with time. If there is decrease in the concentration of the reactant, means rate of reaction also decrease. So how concentration of reactant influence the rate of the reaction? With increased concentration of the reaction, rate of reaction becomes faster. So if we add reactant more and more, the rate of the reaction becomes fast and fast. Next factor is temperature. With increase in temperature, rate of reaction also increases. In most of the reaction, the rate of the reaction becomes just double by increase in 10 degrees centigrade. Means if we increase a temperature by 10 degrees Celsius, there is an increase in rate of reaction just double. Clear? Fifth factor is surface area of reactant. If our reactant is solid, then its surface area also influences the rate of the reaction. Larger the surface area, more will be the rate of the reaction. Clear? And this is the reason why when we take log of wood or when we take pieces of wood catches fire more rapidly as compared to the log of wood. That's all for today. Hope you like the video. If you like, please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you will get the notification of my new video. Thank you.